Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Please all stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent word to Jeroboam, king of Israel. Amos has conspired against you here within Israel. The country cannot endure all his words. For this is what Amos says: Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel shall surely be exiled from its land. To Amos, Amaziah said, "Off with you, visionary, flee to the land of Judah. There, earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, 'Go prophesy to my people Israel. Now hear the word of the Lord.' You say, 'Prophesy not against Israel, preach not against the house of Isaac.' Now thus says the Lord, 'Your wife shall be made a harlot in the city, and your sons and daughters shall fall by the sword. Your land shall be divided by measuring line, and you yourself shall die in an unclean land. Israel shall be exiled far from its land.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just.
They are more precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold, sweeter also than syrup or honey from the comb.
The judgments of the Lord are true, and all of them are just. Please all stand.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ and entrusting to us the message of reconciliation.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After entering a boat, Jesus made the crossing and came to his own town. And there people brought to him a paralytic lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Courage, child, your sins are forgiven." At that, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, "Why do you harbor evil thoughts? Which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins." He then said to the paralytic, "Rise, pick up your stretcher and go home." He rose and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God who had given such authority to men. My sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon to all of you, my dear brothers and sisters. Whenever I facilitate recollections and retreats, the most heartwarming and moving part is when the participants courageously and tearfully forgive one another, concluding with an embrace of acceptance and welcome. My dear brothers and sisters, forgiveness is acceptance. It is the recognition of another person's worth and value, despite his or her imperfections and external deformities. The person in our gospel today is a paralytic. And by this, we understand that he is physically challenged, a person so marginalized and avoided. My dear brothers and sisters, religious beliefs prevalent in the time of our Lord Jesus forbid association with such persons. Sickness is indicative of a punishment for sinfulness and dealing with the sick in sharing in that punishment, which renders the person unclean and impure and disabling him or her for entering the temple. Jesus debunked and even defied this prohibition, giving the sick the understanding, attention, and concern. In our society, there are many people who are sick. They are not only those who are physically ill, but also those who have become our problems because of their delinquencies in different behaviors and unbecoming attitudes. They are the ills of society which many reject. Do we Christians turn away from them? My dear brothers and sisters, as Christians, we are not only challenged, but also called to extend our hands and reach out to their kind. I believe this is a key to that transformed society we all dream and pray for. A society characterized by love for all. A society characterized by acceptance and welcoming. This is our vocation as followers of the Lord. The gospel tells us that when we welcome, accept, and forgive those we despise and hate, we proclaim that we are truly following Him. We are, in a way, personifying God's attributes of love and forgiveness.
Please all stand.
With all the trust of the paralytic's friends, let us bring to the Lord the needs and miseries of the church and of the world. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church of God may be constantly at work in carrying out Christ's saving mission through the forgiveness of sins. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That priests who celebrate the sacrament of reconciliation may always show compassion and understanding to penitents. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may always be ready to forgive others, realizing that this is the shared duty of all who follow Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the handicapped may find comfort and hope in their sufferings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all those who have died may share in Christ's eternal peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the forgiveness shown to us by your Son. May we in turn show forgiveness to all who have offended us. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep into the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Peace be with you. Peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Friends, this is Jesus, our Savior, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to receive him.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
My soul finds rest in God alone. My salvation comes from Him. He alone is my rock, my salvation, my fortress. I shall never be afraid. I shall never be afraid.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagpalang nilikha, ipinagliing walang sana, pusong dalisay dakila. Maria, ina ng Ama.
Thank you.